First of all, we should understand why we need to meditate. Right? Meditation is not to gain some extraordinary siddhis or power. It is not for that. Or meditation is not just to get some sort of peace of mind. It is not for that also. Or if I meditate, maybe I may excel in my profession or in life. If you think that way, yes, it is right. But that is only a byproduct. You understand what I am saying? So meditation is not just to excel in your profession or in your life. Actually, meditation is to find the source of everything. The source of all knowledge, the source of all power, and the source of all love. So what is the source of all knowledge? What is the source of all power and all love? That is my own true self. Our scriptures say, Aham Brahmasmi. See, when I say self, you should not misunderstand. There are two sort of self we talk about. One is the ego self, small I we say. The personality, the ego. That is also called as I only. I, Ahankaram Sarva, that I. But when you transcend that I, that Ahankar, that ego, and when that I dies, then reveal the true self, the true I. So that true self, which is called as Paramatma, or Pati, or Shivam, whichever way you call it, or you may call it as Allah, or you can call it as the Buddhahood, whatever you want to call it, or if you want to call it as emptiness, whatever you want to call it, that is the source of all knowledge, all power, and all love. So, that is here in our own hearts, the self, the true self. So, meditation is to turn the mind from the world of objects, emotions and thoughts and focus it on oneself, the true self, and to discover the true self and to abide in it. I will repeat. See, mind means what? Mind is nothing but flow of thoughts. Like river is flow of waters, mind is nothing but flow of thoughts. Now the mind is always extrovert and getting lost only in the world. It is shattered in different places, in time, past, present, future, and in different objects. So our minds are continuously shattered. Some of you, you are sitting here, you are as if looking at me, but your minds may have gone somewhere. So when we are sitting here, the mind has a knack of just going anywhere it wants. You understand? So to gather all those rays and then to focus that on oneself, in a search of who am I, and to dive within and to discover one's true nature, that is called as the God or Paramatma. Not that small eye, the ego, that is very poisonous. That is the source of all evil. That small eye called as Pashu in Siddhanta terminology, or Ahankaram, or the Jiva, the individuality. That I am not talking about the self. That is a false self. So when you inquire, what is my true self? And when you dive within and abide, that is meditation actually. Why? When you reach the source of all knowledge, all power, all love, then that is the real life. Then you live life king size. You understand? So that is meditation. So to go about, what is required? One of our Swami, he's a great Acharya, he used to say, put the mind into put process. That is meditation. What is that? Put the mind into put process. Put means what? P-U-T. Put process. That is meditation. What is put process? P. Purify the mind. U. Unify the mind. T. Transcend the mind. Meaning, in our effort to turn our mind and focus on our own self, what we have to do to start with, we have to purify the mind. Why? Now the mind is full of raga dvesha, likes and dislikes, desire, attachment, and so much of confusion, all vulgar sort of things inside. So the mind has to be purified first. And then that mind which is purified is available for concentration or meditation. Then we focus the mind, that is unify the mind. And once the mind is unified, it gathers tremendous strength. So then you have to apply yourself. That is a technique where you can transcend the mind. So when the mind is transcended, then the true self is revealed, because the true self is just behind the mind. Means the confusion of the thought, the true self is as if covered. So when all the thoughts subside, when the mind is transcended, there you are with your true self, which is the source of everything. So how to purify the mind? Yes, that is where we have to go to the temple, worship the Lord, sing His glory. Those things are very helpful. Go for Tirtha Yatra, attend satsangs like this. These are all to purify the mind. You understand? And if you are doing any action, do it with the right bhavana. Meaning offering to the Lord, and whatever comes, accept as His prasad. These are all the ways to purify the mind. So once the mind is purified, next effort is to unify the mind. You know why? When the mind which is scattered, which is just roaming everywhere, is a weak mind. Meaning, that mind cannot resist temptation. That mind cannot face challenges. That mind cannot think properly. That mind cannot take good decisions. And that mind is full of negativities. But at the same time, if you gather the thoughts and if you can focus it on one object of meditation for some time, when the mind is focused, the same mind gathers strength. It becomes more powerful. How this can happen? One of our physics lecturers, he used to explain. See, you have seen magnet, no? Magnet, just ordinary magnet. It attracts iron piece, right? How is it possible? At the same time, if you take an ordinary iron piece, is it attracting any other objects? No. What is the difference? The magnet is also just an iron piece only. But you know what the difference is in the iron piece? Please follow me carefully. The molecules are oriented in different direction. When the molecules are oriented in different direction, the sort of the potential or the energy, whatever you call of one molecule, is cancelled because it's oriented in something, some other direction. So other molecules are oriented in other direction. Likewise, when they are oriented in different direction, the energy or whatever power, whatever you call the field, is cancelled mutually, and it's just an iron piece. But if you want to make that iron piece a magnet, what you have to do? We have learned in our science lab, take a small piece of magnet and then rub that iron piece in one direction. When you rub, what happens? All the molecules which are oriented in different direction, they just come and then they orient in one direction. When all of them orient in one direction, all the energy field or whatever, the power, the potential, all of them add up, and then it becomes a magnet which can attract. Similarly, the mind which is distracted, which is shattered, becomes a weak mind, and we cannot achieve anything, either this world or of that world. That mind which is focused, concentrated, acquires, gathers great strength. It can do wonders. Swami Vivekananda. If you utter that name, Swami Vivekananda, what an inspiration. Why? Because he lived his life that way. Why? How is it possible? Because he is a yogi, a great man of meditation. So therefore, when he said, from that yogic power, dear sisters and brothers of America, everybody started, oh, wonderful. But if you and I go and tell, everybody will say, ah, okay, what next? You know, means that creates power. His words gathers a lot of power because of his yoga shakti. It's not just like that. It's brahmacharya and yoga shakti it is. So therefore, meditation in the initial stage is to gather the mind. So what we have to do? We keep an object of meditation and we try to focus our attention on that object of meditation. Let us say, we take the form of the Lord, Lord Muruga, let us say. So we chant his divine name, Om Saravana Bhavaya Namaha. And then we focus our mind only on that divine form of, let us say, Sydney Murugan. Again and again, again and again, you chant his divine name, whatever mantra or whatever, and focus your mind there. When you do it continuously, mind gets focused. But that will not happen overnight, because we have spoiled our mind for ages. So the mind will go again and again, start roaming here and there. But the effort in meditation is to bring in the mind again and again. Yata yata nischarati manas sanchalam astiram tata tata niyamya atmanyeva vayam nashet. Gita says, whenever you find your mind getting out of focus, scattering, means roaming here and there, again and again bring back the mind and keep it on the focus, on the object of meditation. This is unifying the mind. This is meditation to start with, in the beginning stage. So once when you really master yourself in this technique of focusing the mind, unifying the mind gathers strength. Not only that, it gets trained. See, even in the ordinary world, who is successful? That person who can keep the mind where his hands are at work, he is successful. That is what our Yoga Swami says. Kayyum meyyum karuthirku isaiha. Seivana yellam sevvane seiha. See how beautiful. Seivana yellam sevvane seiha. Kayyum meyyum karuthirku isaiha. Meaning, keep the mind where your hands are at work. So, when you start meditating, when you train your mind only to focus on the object of meditation, now for this half an hour, I will not go here and there anywhere. I am going to just only focus on this object of meditation. When you train yourself, even when you work in the world outside, the same habit continues. Whatever work you are doing, the mind is there. That is the ingredient for success. Wherever, whatever you are doing, if the mind is available and if it is focused there, there you are. Am I right or wrong? But now our problem is, whatever we do, mind is not available. படிக்க போகும்போது தான் கிரிக்கெட் பார்க்கணும்னு ஆசை வருது. ஐயோ கிரிக்கெட் நல்லா போயிட்டுருக்குமே, நான் படிச்சுட்டு இருக்கேன். கிரிக்கெட் பார்க்கும்போது பயம் வருது, ஐயோ படிக்காமல் கிரிக்கெட் பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கேன், ஐயோ ஐயோ நாளைக்கு எக்ஸாம். ஸோ வி ஆர் அன்ஏபிள் டு என்ஜாய் எனி திங் பிகாஸ் அவர் மைண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் இன் எனிவேர். யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வாட் ஐ எம் சேயிங்? ஸோ இஃப் யூ ஹவ் ட்ரெயின்ட் யுவர் செல்ஸ், ஈவன் 10 minutes, இஃப் யூ டேக் யுவர் புக் அண்ட் இஃப் யூ ஸ்டடி, இஃப் யூ ரீட், everything will be clear. It goes within because your mind is available. It is very sharp because you have trained your mind. It has got a special power of absorbing things. So this is the benefit of unifying the mind. But after that, how to transcend the mind? Transcending the mind means what? Whatever the thought arises, you have to just watch. Good or bad or vulgar thought, whatever thought arises, you need not do anything. Just be a sakshi matram and watch and observe the thoughts. Yathaan Yoga Swami sonnar, muttaadu poosai seyin sonnar. Muttaadu poosai sey. Meaning what? When you sit quiet, in this technique, this is the second technique I am talking about, to transcend the mind. In this technique, you just sit quiet. If the thought comes, let it come. If the thought dances, let it dance. If it goes, let it go. I have nothing to do with this thought. Whether it is good, bad, or it is vulgar, I have nothing to do with it. Vanda va, irunda iru, pona po. வந்தால் ஏன் வந்தேன்னு கேட்க மாட்டேன், இருந்தால் ஏன் இருக்கேன்னு கேட்க மாட்டேன், போனால் ஏன் போனேன்னு கேட்க மாட்டேன். லைக் தேட், இஃப் யூ கேன் ஜஸ்ட் அப்சர்வ் அண்ட் வாட்ச் த தாட், சும்மா இருந்தோம்னா, ஜஸ்ட் பார்த்துட்டே இருந்தோன்னா, பா சுரண்டி பார்க்காதேன்னு சொல்கிறார் யோகர் சுவாமி. இஃப் யூ கேன் அப்சர்வ் த மைண்ட் வித் பர்ஃபெக்ட் டிட்டாச்மெண்ட், விதவுட் மெடலிங் வித் த தாட், விதவுட் மெடலிங் வித் த தாட். ஹவு வி மெடல் வித் த தாட்? வி கிவ் பாசிட்டிவ் வேல்யூ ஆர் நெகட்டிவ் வேல்யூ. Either we indulge in the thought or we resist the thought. See, please understand. More you resist the thought, more it will gain power, more you gain strength. Oh, na nalla paiyan, enak inda ketta nanappala varakudadu. Oh, kadavule inda nanappu varakudadu, varakudadu na. It will come with force. That is the nature of the mind. Then what you should do? Vanda vandittu povudu, irunda irundittu povudu. Or ketta nanappu vandhaal na ketta manushana aida maten. When I entertain that wrong thought, I become. I lower myself. But let it come, let it dance, let it go. I am the Sachaitanya Swarupam and these thoughts cannot do anything to me. And you just watch and observe the mind, the thoughts. Sometimes the thought dances. After that, it goes. If you allow the thoughts to pass, it will pass. But we don't allow the thoughts to pass. We go on meddling with the thought. Either we indulge, or we resist, or we verbalize, or we analyze, we judge, we do so many things. Instead, just watch and observe the thought. See, actually we give power to the thought to disturb us or to bind us. The thoughts can never bind us. Because of our likes and dislikes, because we love certain things, we hate certain other things, we give the power to the mind to disturb us. If we can remain neutral without any like or dislike, venunu solla maten venanu solla maten chumma irpen appadi paathute irundonu sonna, thoughts let it come, let it go, whatever happens happens, I just remain the sakshi. So this is how we have to transcend the mind. So once the mind is done, meaning what? After some time, the mind loses its potency to bind you or to disturb you. So the thoughts will just die down. And there will come a stage where there are no thoughts. You have transcended the thought. Chitta vritti nirodha yoga, Patanjali Yoga Sutra says. So you can remain in a state where you are not disturbed by any thought. Just you remain. And there the truth is revealed. There you need not know the truth because you can never know the truth. You know what? Even Brahma and Vishnu, they went in search of Adi and Mudi of Shiva. They could never fathom the Adi or Mudi. Who are we, you and I, to know the truth? Nobody can know the truth. If the Ahankara dies, then the truth is revealed. Meaning what? It is revealed to you. Meaning what? You can only be the truth. You cannot know the truth. It has said that Arunachal Tattva. Arunachal Tattva is what is Brahma and Vishnu are Adi Mudiya Kaanam Mudla. But you and me, where are Adi Mudiya Kaanam? அவன் அறிய முடியாது, அவனை பணியத்தான் முடியும். ஸோ இன் மெடிடேஷன், வென் யுவர் மைண்ட் இஸ் ஃபோக்கஸ்ட் அண்ட் வென் யூ சிட் குவாய்ட், சும்மா இருந்தோம்னு சொன்னால் எவ்ரி திங் டைஸ் டவுன் அண்ட் பை இட் செல்ஃப் த ஆத்மா த ட்ரூத் இஸ் ரிவீல்ட் அண்ட் யூ என்டர் டு அ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டைமென்ஷன் வேர் இட் இஸ் த பீஸ் தட் பாஸத் த அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் வேர் It is not duality, it is beyond. Where it is not the world and I, it is just the one. So that happens. So this is the meditation as far as I know. Means I know means what? Whatever our gurus have taught us. So it is first to purify the mind. For that everything is required. Temple visit, worship of the Lord, developing devotion to the Lord, singing His glories, vratam, teertha yatra, everything is to purify the mind. Because our mind is so confused and so polluted now. See, another important thing I want to tell you. Now Indian government is going to spend thousands of crores of rupees to clean Ganga. Our Gurudev once he blasted, what nonsense, cleaning Ganga, stop polluting Ganga, it is always pure. We only pollute Ganga by allowing all the industrial waste to mix and to sort of go with it. And then we take a broom and we say cleaning Ganga. You stop polluting Ganga, Ganga is always pure. Similarly, we pollute our mind with wrong inputs and then we say we are going to clean the mind. First of all, stop polluting the mind. Garbage in, garbage out, you know. When you put garbage inside, only garbage can come out of you. Whatever you are reading or you are seeing is all garbage. Hearing is garbage, talking is garbage. Means everything will be garbage only. The output from you is only garbage. That is why Mahatma Gandhi said, don't see evil, don't hear evil, don't talk evil. Meaning what? We should not voluntarily go on putting rubbish into our minds. We have to be very careful. We should only put the right thing into our mind. So this is purifying the mind. And then, as I told you, unifying the mind by concentrating on one object of meditation. And then just by observing the thoughts, by being a witness, muttadu pusa senjona, then we transcend the mind. And after in the transcending of the mind, there is no knowing of the truth. It is just being the self. And in that being, the truth or the source of all is revealed to you. And there you are. This is in gist what is meditation. This is the gist of meditation. Right. I have concluded.
மனத வழிபடுத்துறதுக்கு உணவில் ஏதாவது தாக்கம் இருக்கா?
எஸ் டெஃபினெட்லி. சி, ஃபார் வாட்சிங் த மைண்ட் யூ நீட் பேலன்ஸ், யூ நீட் அலர்ட்னஸ், அவேர்னஸ். ஸோ தட் வில் கம் வித் சத்வா. So you have to develop sattva to be alert. Pasithiru, tanithiru, vilithiru, padavikittu. Pasithiru na eppadi pasichirukkadunnilla. The thirst to know the higher. Tanithiru na kootathil seyrama taniya ukkandirpenilla. Tanithiru na enthom. Semmari attukutta mari ellam seyradha na seyapodilla. Enakkum oru taniyana vision irukku, paadai irukku, na tanithiru irukku. Vilithiru na means what? Alert, be alert. So mind alert a irukkadhukku sattvam theva. For that sattvam only we have to eat sattvic food. Adhaan Gurudeva solvar Swami Chinmayananda, don't make your stomach a graveyard, burial ground. Because we are making our stomach a burial ground only, na? We are burying the dead objects, dead things. Koliya vetti adha podaikkirom, aala vetti podaikkirom, poi kanda kandadala innum na solradhe enak vai kus adella vetti vetti ulla podaikkirom illaya. If you make your stomach the burial ground, your mind will become very mandam, meaning what? Dull, not fit for meditation. And it leads to only rajas and tamas. That is why there is so much of confusion in this world. I tell you, the confusion is because, the violence, the aggression is because we eat wrong food. And we justify saying, where will you get proteins? Where will you get this? Where will you get that? As if our forefathers were not having proteins. They have lived a wonderful life, 90 to 100 years. And these doctors are to be blamed. அவங்களுக்கு ஒண்ணுமே தெரியாது உடம்பு பத்தி. தே கன்ஃபியூஸ் எவ்ரிபடி. ஓஹோ யூ யூ ஷுட் ஈட் திஸ், சின்ன குழந்தைக்கு இதெல்லாம் கொடுத்தாதான் அது வளரும். வாட் நான்சென்ஸ். சீ, த நான் வெஜிடேரியன் ஃபுட் டெஸ்ட்ராய்ஸ் யுவர் மைண்ட்ஸ், யூனோ தட் புனித தன்மையை கெடுத்துடுது. அண்ட் யூ பிகம் ஆல் ராட்சசாஸ் பை ஈட்டிங் ஆல் திஸ் நான்சென்ஸ். ஐ எம் சாரி டு டெல் யூ தட். தட் இஸ் வை சோ மச் ஆஃப் வயலன்ஸ் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட், சோ மச் ஆஃப் அக்ரஷன். ஸோ தேர்ஃபோர் food is very, very important. If you want to be a meditator growing in inner life, you need to eat sattva food. All the mahatmas have said, not one or two, all the mahatmas have said. But if you want to only go in the world and get lost in the world, you can do anything you want. No, nobody can stop. But if you want to really know the truth, you have to be sattvic. To develop sattva, you need to eat right food. Not only right food, as I told you, even the inputs what you put through other senses also should be sattvic. You understand? And what you talk also should be very pleasant and very good, all not harsh words. இனிய உளவாக இன்னாத கூறம் கனி இருப்ப காய் கவர்ந்தற்று. So therefore that is important. I am sorry to have been very harsh. I don't know why I said that way. Okay.
Swami, in the world so many millions are eating non-veggies. Hmm. Is it, are they creating sin?
No, it's not sin or anything. See, when you eat a lot of non-veg, because it's all gross food. Second thing is, when you kill that animal, that animal dies with fear. So that those things subtly it goes with the flesh. So when you eat that, you develop lot of fear, lot of aggression, or more viri. இதெல்லாம் உண்டாறது காரணம் நம்ம சாப்பிட்ற உணவுல தான் இருக்கு. See, in this world there is a UN, peacekeeping, these, that, so many things. But how much of violence in this world? Everybody is killing, beheading, and killing. Why? Because everybody has become rakshasas, like very ferocious in their minds, because of the food. I would say because of the food. Maybe there may be other factors also, but mainly because of food. It's not sin or anything, but if you want to be a good person, sattvic person, who wants to know the higher self, then definitely you have to change your food habits slowly. But there also in our scriptures it is said, if you are a kshatriya, if you are on the battlefield trying to fight a war, then you can eat, because for that you need rajas. To kill somebody you need that rajas, so that is fine. If you are in the Australian cricket squad, if you are a Brett Lee, if you have to bowl 130 km per hour, You need some sort of a, that kind of a raw power. Then you have to eat. Thaisa and Sabas, Jaugal Sina, Mari, Odi, and the Porta, Nood would have a romantic, Yambal would have a romantic. You understand what I'm saying? Jaugal Sina is a vegetarian. I'm just joking. So for that you need, but otherwise, you know, for the sattva is good. And Jiva Karunyam also. For you to enjoy, how can you harm anybody, any being, any living being? In that context also, Jiva Karunya context also, it's important. Yeah.